Listen, it's niggas hating on me, your girlfriends want me, and bad decisions always make for the best stories. And I don't know what you want from me, because you the one I'm trying to wake up to every damn morning, and the people about to know, they all about to see us. So violated cause far away from the freest rap game, didn't know it, but it needed us. If we told you what we did last summer, wouldn't believe us, but my mama said pray for them niggas that hate. They just wanna be in your place, but them niggas ain't true, cause them niggas ain't real. While I'm them niggas, put on all them chains and shine on, shine on, shine on them niggas. Shine on them niggas, shine on them niggas. Shine on, shine on, shine on them niggas. Shine on them niggas, shine on them niggas. Shine on, shine on. Bad bitches, do you need that?
Do you need that?
I give it to you if you need that. Got it for you if you need that. I put it down if you need that. Tell me, do you need that?
Do you need that?
Bad bitches, do you need that? I got it for you if you need that. Let me know if you need that.
Let it play, let it play. 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 That's what I was waiting on.
rich girl. You ain't gotta serve no more.
Is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee. Rumor has it. On the Breakfast Club.
So listen up.
Well, Kirk Franklin's son, Carrion, posted a recording of an argument that the two of them had. And he posted, "This is why I'm done. No father should speak to their children like this. If I have any issues, it's because of this type of treatment that I deal with behind closed doors." Listen to this.
Okay. If you think I'm reading this paper, let me say it like this. When your hands that gets your skinny motherfucker ass back out the goddamn way before I put my foot in your
I dare you.
I don't see nothing wrong with it. My dad would talk to me if I talked to my dad crazy immediately, and that man is 33 years old. So absolutely, I don't see nothing wrong with it.
All right, well, Kirk Franklin responded, and he did apologize.
"We've tried for many years through counseling, through therapy, to try to rectify this private family matter. Recently, my son and I had an argument that he chose to record. I felt extremely disrespected in that conversation, and I lost my temper, and I said words that are not appropriate, and I'm sincerely sorry to all of you. During that conversation, I called the family therapist and got that therapist on the phone to try to help. He never played that part of the recording. I'm not perfect. I'm human, and I'm going to make mistakes, and I'm trying to get it right. Please keep me and my family in your prayers."
Yeah, I mean, this is one of those times when, you know, you got to hear all sides, but truthfully, I don't have to hear all sides, because that's family business. Like,
That's family business, absolutely.
That son is 33 years old. That's not a little boy. I don't know why Kirk spoke to him like that, but I'm sure he had a good reason. And
Part of the reason is we can see, like, you release that audio trying to ruin your dad's career. Like you said, that's family business.
Well, no, but we've all gotten arguments. We don't know how it got to that point, though.
I mean, it doesn't matter. We all have had arguments with our parents, our sisters, our brothers, our situations, and I would pray that no matter what, whatever is family business is family business. You don't release an audio, try to embarrass your dad.
Yeah, of course.
No matter what it is.
But that's after the fact. No. We don't know what got them to that point. But like I said before, it doesn't matter to me, because that's their family business. And that's a grown-ass man.
He's not a child. He's 33 years old.
Carrion responded on his Instagram story. He wrote, "He apologized to his fans only and not me. This is why I'm done." And then Kirk Franklin's daughter, who's Carrion's sister, Kennedy, went on social media and said, "This wasn't the last family pick we took. I'm really tired of this. If you want to air out things, I can do that too. I still have the screenshots. We all have screenshots and recordings too. What was so bad about your childhood? You were a black privileged boy. You were legit fed with a silver spoon and given countless opportunities. You just didn't take them. So what? Now you're mad because you're 33 and have nothing to show." Here's what else Kennedy said.
"I'll go to war. There's always another side to the story. And
yep.
I'm sorry if somebody keeps on disrespecting me and spewing out falsely allegations that could ruin my reputation and like that. I will cuss them the hell out as well. Sorry.
Absolutely.
I've just learned from previous experiences, whether it's with him or anything like that. Family don't mean nothing. Like, you don't got to be blood to be somebody's family."
Yeah, that's why I said it's family business. We got that one phone call. That's one glimpse, one side. We don't know what made it get to that point, but even still, that's their family business.
It's nobody's business but their own. At 99 years old, my grandmother would still whoop my ass if I stepped out of line. And I wouldn't do nothing. At my pops is 70-something years old. He would still whip my ass if I did something wrong and stepped out of line.
And
that's how our family rocks. I don't know about anybody else's family, but Big Mama, she runs the family. And if you disrespect Big Mama, it is what it is.
And it's
also, that's my family. It's also sad
if you call a man, you know, a bitch ass N word, and then they do something like, you know, release your recording.
It proves
you're proving them right.
Yeah,
in a lot of ways. Okay.
Well, plot twist, Plies went on social media and said he sounded just like me on that phone. Hashtagging none of us perfect. That was not my dog on that phone. That was me. I take full responsibility for those actions.
But even I don't understand why Kirk Franklin can't curse. Kirk Franklin never claimed to be perfect. Like, just because he makes gospel music, he can't curse?
Bro.
He can't let his emotions get the best of him sometimes?
Bro. And you ever got cursed?
And that's your
I
child.
Know you got cursed out by your pops before.
Man, please. I used to get beat with extension cords.
All right? Ainsley, I know you got cursed out by your pops before.
Of course.
Okay, all right.
But I'm just saying, that's a 33-year-old grown man. Like, I mean, I'm sure that it was a lot that, you know, got to that point for Kirk to react like that. But that's their feeling.
All right, well, that is your rumor report.
All right, thank you, Missy. Charlamagne, who are you giving that donkey to?
Now, there's no excuses for this young man, all right? Well, he's not a young man. He's an older man, but his name is Matt Rowan. We'll talk about it for after the hour.
All right, we'll get to that next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
Chicks down in Texas, all the way to New Orleans where the girls cook catfish. And in LA, every chick's an actress. Hollywood status with the shaded glasses. To Detroit, yeah, the place that I rest, where the ladies got asses and la-la sex. And Hot Atlanta, y'all, is one of the best, where they speak Southern slang and smoke Lysess. And New York women are way too fresh, too much on your mind, let me ease that stress. I wish you all were mine, it's so selfish. Maybe I'm feeling myself too much, I guess. But to my ladies all across the globe, in small towns that I don't even know, no. To all local international code, whether you see me in streets or catch me at shows, I'm calling.
Yeah, maybe I'm selfish. I want you to myself, I can't help it.
All my,
yeah, maybe I'm selfish.
You're my ladies and I can't.
Maybe I'm selfish.
Let you,
I want you to myself, I can't help it.
Be with, yeah, no one, yeah, but me, yeah, yeah, baby.
Now don't be trying to come around my girl acting like Mr. Friendly and steal the spotlight like Mr. Bentley. I spotted her like Spud McKenzie, and for them fake boobies I paid them Benjis. Get your own. I got Paris, he got Nicki, he tried to get him a clone. He said, yeah, you know you got extra hoes and everything you do is extra cold, from the polo fleece to the Jesus piece. I got family in high places like Jesus, niece. Can I please say my piece? If y'all fresh to death, then I'm deceased. And this one here is a heat rock, spit like a beatbox, the way the beat rocks, new version of Pete Rock. But for that Benz, I get CL love, so I switch my girls around like 3L Dub. I'm calling.
Yeah, maybe I'm selfish.
I'll
I want you to myself, I can't help it.
All my,
yeah, maybe I'm selfish.
You're my ladies and I can't.
Maybe I'm selfish.
Let you,
I want you to myself, I can't help it.
Yeah, no one, yeah, but me, yeah, baby.
What up, Pam? How your little man doing in New Jersey? Last I heard, he caught the flu and you was worried. Hope he feels better. And thanks, Jonetta from Cleveland, for that good head and your Jetta. Better believe it, Shanice, you my piece from Compton. Before I'm off the plane, make sure you cop some trees to spark up. Danielle, ATL, got them pictures in the mail. You sealed with a kiss and you sent it with Chanel. You looking good in that one, showing off your body. Had a Beverly Hills mommy that would buy me Cardis. Take me to after parties, her name was Kari. And it sucks that we didn't keep in touch, I'm sorry. But hey, Kim, how's Minneapolis? You so pretty, hate you show off your titties for silly classes. Cause I love you girls, though you ain't mine. I wish my arms was long enough to hug you all at the same time.
I'm calling, yeah, maybe I'm selfish.
Out,
I want you to myself, I can't help it.
All my,
yeah, maybe I'm selfish.
You're my ladies and I can't.
Maybe I'm selfish.
Let you,
I want you to myself, I can't help it.
Be with,
yeah,
no one,
yeah,
but me,
yeah,
baby.